Okay, I have my project in Atalec. Definitely in mine, in main.c, is everything very similar to the previous configuration. I can go here into my configuration, go to declaration. Here you can see again the baud rate, I set the instance, I set the word length, everything is how I want it. Then I can control also in the init, I will check the MSP file, what is in the MSP initialization. Definitely again I'm checking the instance, I'm enabling the clock for the UART. I'm setting the correct pins. You can see it's still the same. I'm setting the alternate function, that the alternate function with which the GPIOs need to cooperate is the UART1. And here I'm also enabling the interrupt for my UART. Then you know that we have this in our XTLab. Then after this, the core can create the interrupt because the interrupt is enabled. In the IT.c, we can again found the interrupt handler and also the cube MX for us create the HL interrupt handler. Now, what is left for us? Definitely we need to define the callbacks. Because now this UART will have not only one callback, but we have the one callback for the transmission. I expect also second for the reception. Then we need to find these callbacks. Then like before, these callbacks will be in the drivers, in the HL driver, in the sources. And before we search for the callbacks in the GPIO.c, because we have the XT. But now, because we have the UART, then we will search in the STM32F4X6_HL_UART.c. Then we will go into UART, and because we know that the callback starting with the week, because they are not defined, then I will try to search for the week. We have the MSP init, but we already using MSP init, also MSP dainit. This is not for us. But I definitely have the transmit complete callback, and I have the half transfer complete callback. Then I will use the transfer complete callback. In my main, I put it here. Why not? Oh, sorry. And also I will search for the next one, and also reception half complete callback and reception complete callback. Then I'm okay with the reception complete callback. Then I have very nice callbacks for the transmission and reception. I think here still is no problem. I can search for the more callbacks. You can see we have also callbacks for the error, and this is everything. Then we have one callback for transmission and second one for the reception. Now I can put here, for example, my while one function. To allow me put here the breakpoint or stop here after I receive all this data. And for the transmission and reception, we need to create the buffers. Then I create the 8-bit unsigned buffer for the transmission. I don't know, 10 bytes, I like the number. And I will send some valid numbers. I don't know, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. To 19, it's the 10. And I will create the second buffer for the reception. Again, 10. 10 bytes. is the mistake. Okay, then I have two buffers. Then I now only need to call the functions. Again, it will start the HL underscore UART. Because I'm, okay, it's the USART in the reference manual, but I'm using this PFA now as a UART. Then this is why I'm missing the S. And first, I will start with the reception, because it's not blocking function, then I need to call the reception first before I start to send the data. Then don't forget on this. And because we're using the interrupt, then I need to use the underscore IT. If you not use the underscore IT here, that using the pooling version, then which is blocking, and you cannot send then the data. Then first I need to use the IT. First parameter, as usual, the handle. I can check here. I think it's okay. It will be the H. UART 1. The second parameter, he not helping me. No, he don't want to help me. I need to go to declaration. Second parameter is the pointer to the data. And last is the size. Then it will be buffer for the receive. Then I want to receive 10 bytes. And this is everything. After this, my UART will expect more data for reception. And for the transmit, it will be very similar. It will be transmit underscore IT. Again, first parameter will be handle, starting with the H and the USART number one. Then the pointer to the buffer for the transmission. And last, how many bytes I want to send. And this is everything from this part. And after this, the transmit and receiving will work automatically. Then we can try. I can compile my code. So I check if build is successful. Maybe I forget here to change also the optimization to see the buffers. Then don't forget to change the optimization here, settings, optimization, normal. Okay, it was changed. Compile again. Now I can go to debug and see what will happen. I put for sure the breakpoint here into the receive complete callback. And for check, I put here the breakpoint in the time when I'm setting the transmit IT. Then I assume, see still no callback. Then I start transmitting, and because I connect my wires together, I get the callback. Then inside here, I can check my reception buffer. And we can see, what is inside. It's not so nice. But it's 10, 11, 12. And everything is inside. Then it seems that he really sent what I wanted. It's very nice. Then this works. Then this works for me. I think it's very nice. Then now you know how to transmit and receive the buffers. Okay, now I can also a little bit modify my example to return back into my CubeMX. Yes, here. And for example, I will add also the second UART, the UART 2, which you now know. It's for the VTRACOM port on my Nuclo. Okay. And in this UART, I set the configuration UART 2, and I also use the interrupts. Then I will have in the same time two UARTs with the interrupts. Okay. I can save my project and I can regenerate my project. Okay, my project is already open, and it's not necessary to open it again. You can see here I have two UARTs. Because I store everything between the user sections, it was preserved. It's good. In the it.c, we can see the handler from the UART1 and UART2. But now what we need to check also, we have here only one callback. Then if you remember well, from the XT, we need to discover which periphery triggers this callback. Then for this, we here put again the if. We have here the handle, which is perfect, because we can put here the question, if this handle is used with the instance which belongs to SART1, if yes, we can do something. I will put here no operation. And if this UART belongs this instance to USART2, USART2, then do something. And this is in case that we have multiple UARTs or USARTs using the same callback. Then we can compile the code. And I can put here the breakpoints. And I can go to debug. And we will see what will happen. Some error. Maybe I have here something wrong. I will try to rebuild it again. It seems that my Nuclo was stuck. The debugger was wrongly unconnected. I here for sure terminate the debugging session. And I will try to enter the debug again. Now is everything okay, it seems? No? Oh. Yes, because I rebuilt the complete project. Also check the project settings. If there is still non optimization, this seems okay. Then I will try this last time. No symbol table loaded. This is nice error. Okay, now we are in the debug. We have here our two. Not two callbacks, okay, it's a different one. Okay, then give me a few seconds. I need to copy there the callbacks. Okay, now I can go into my main. I have here two breakpoints. I can see if we use them. Then I run the code. And then immediately here in my breakpoint, when I receive the data on the UART. I think this is not okay. Then we can try it again. Okay. Try it again. It now seems that is valid with my ID. Okay, we are stopped here. We see that the instance is HUART1. And if we step the code, I think he still optimized the code too much. I think the no operation is good part. Could hear the while one, which will be a little bit better breakpoint. Then we will see. Okay. Go to debug. Run it. If I stop it. I received the data from the UART1. Then it's correct. Then he recognized which UART do this. When you try to change this, and instead of, for example, UART1 here, we can receive data from the UART2. Why not? Then he will wait for the data from the UART2. Then I skip this one. Receive here UART2. I compile my code. Then I will run my debug, and in the same time can run the code, and I need also the terminal. I have here my terminal. I open the correct port, correct baud rate, click OK. I send many bytes. Okay, and now I can stop here, and you can see we received 10 bytes from my terminal. Then everything is working okay. Then now you also know how to receive or handle callbacks from the both two USARTs. It will be always the same.